with me, and you'll be in a world of pure imagination. Take a look, and you'll see into your imagination.
We waited too long to act. By mid-century, climate change and its tragic consequences were inevitable. Saharan heat waves swept across the Mediterranean. Super hurricanes became the norm. Glaciers melted and their fresh water was lost. Seas rose and maps were redrawn. People were forced to migrate and cities became crowded. But we prevailed and learned from the mistakes of our forebears. Eventually, we defeated corporate fossil fuel powers and decarbonized our energy and transport systems, an admirable feat that united the world and empowered civil society. By 2100, we achieved a higher level of human development than the materialistic dreams of our ancestors, which only ever came true for a privileged minority. Our society is no longer dominated by the acquisition of monetary wealth and goods, but based on connectedness, health, education, equality, and well-being. We learned that as systems got bigger, corruption and waste seeped in. Rather, we localize and we encourage self-reliance. Food grows where it's eaten, people shop and work where they live, in contrast to the soulless commuter belts and urban sprawl of our past. Both physically and psychologically, we have grown up instead of out. Thank you.
Thank you, Hannah. I love the last bit, the last words, growing up instead of out.
Want to view paradise, simply look around and view it. Anything you want to do it, want to change the world, there's nothing to it.